It's spilt, a knock at the door, and then there's a zillion mom questions or even dad questions that come your way throughout the day. How does a mom or dad stay focused to get anything done, right? Welcome to Mom It Daily, where we talk all things mom and sometimes dad. I'm Trisha Novotny, the mom behind 24/7 Moms, who is also here with her husband, Steve, and together we have survived 5 kids to tell about it. With what seemed to be a zillion kids at times. I mean, really like 5 seems like a lot. And then some of them get married and then there's even more kids, right?
Last night it was just a virtual, well, we have a table that seats 10 and we're like trying to barely squeeze everyone in.
Exactly. So at times it seemed like we had to discover ways that we could actually get things done. How could we avoid distractions? How could we find that solid time to get things done? So in between all that chaos in our lives and the chaos that still continues in our lives, we have some keys or solutions or strategies to share with you today.
Well, it's effective with us because we're both really entrepreneurs and pastors, and we love to do stuff, but it's all independently driven. It's not like somebody's giving us our things to do. We have to create our own lists and our own ways of doing things.
Yep. So today we thought, hey, I know if you're a mom, if you happen to be a dad and you popped in today because you saw this man on right now, we thought maybe you have the same challenges we do, that there's chaos in your life, there's craziness, there's all these different distractions coming your way. What distractions are you allowing into your life that you can actually get rid of? So we're just going to talk a little bit about that this morning. And so the first one is prepare the night prior. That's the first way to help avoid distractions. The most prepared you can be when you get up in the morning, the least distractions you'll have in the morning, right? So first of all, brain dump everything the night before. Like, what are all the things you need to do tomorrow? What are all the things you are thinking about? Brain dump it. Get
rid
of it.
Now, for you, is that like right when you go to bed, or is that in your office? Where do you brain dump?
So, you know, generally I go to my office before we head up to bed and I brain dump. I usually write out my list for the next day and my top things I want to get done, which I'll also talk about that. And I dump it all out. Like, these are things. Because otherwise, I go to bed thinking about it.
Yeah. See, now for me, I can't do that right when I go to bed. I'm really, my sweet spot is if right when I come home from work, I kind of like just get ready for the next day because everything's rolling in my head.
Right.
And then I can let it go after dinner.
But that's still the day prior, right?
It's the day prior.
Brain dump, it helps to prioritize for the next day for you. It gives you a plan. You sleep better. Yep. You don't wake up saying, what will I do? Or what do I want to do? Do I even want to do it? You wake up knowing this is what I'm doing today. This is what's going to happen for my day ahead. So you already don't have that distraction of trying to think, oh my gosh, what am I supposed to do today? And then everything's coming at you in the morning.
Right.
And all of a sudden it's 12 o'clock and you haven't even figured out what you're going to do for the day, right?
Right.
So number one is prepare the night prior. Mm-hmm. Number two is priorities. Create your priority list, your to-do list for the day, which is part of brain dumping, right? So the first thing that I always do is I create my list, and I have 2 lists.
Right.
I create my list for 24/7 Moms, and I create my list for our family, which means things the kids need, things I need to do, things I need to do around the house, dinner, all those things. So there's 2 portions on my to-do list, on my daily sheet. And then there's the top 3 to 5 things that I need to do. That means before I go to bed that night, those are the 3 to 5 things that I want to get done. Whether they're for the family, they're personal, their business, whatever they are, those are the things I want to get done.
Now, I do it a little bit different where, and she is much better at this than I am, but I because I'm not nearly as gifted in organization as she is, but I find with myself, I have to force myself to be organized. And so I lay things out in projects, whether it's even family, like a cabin, or it's a project I'm building, or it's a campaign I'm developing. And I do love the idea, which you pick the top 3 things that you really would like to get done. And so for me, when I have multiple projects, I usually pick 1 to 2 for that day that, okay, 1 to 2, this is a touch point. I got to get it done. And I put it right there and I just look at it.
And that helps. It keeps you going focused, right? Okay, the next one is procrastination first. Procrastination first? What's that mean? What do you keep putting off? What on your list is the hardest for you to do? What do you think? Oh, I think I'll do this because it's easier. I can tend to do that. Look at my list and go, okay, on my list, I'll do these things because they're the easiest, the quickest return I can get from feeling like I accomplished something. But I procrastinate the other things, right? So we waste a lot of energy thinking about these things that we are not, that we keep putting off, that we're not doing, and the energy that we could actually use from that to actually get them done. So rather than always thinking about, oh, I need to clean my garage, which I need to do, I'm constantly procrastinating and not doing it, and I keep adding to the mess out there, versus if I would just spend a day and go do it, I would stop thinking about it. I would stop writing it on my list. So procrastination first. What things can you do today off your list that you keep procrastinating that once you get them off, you'll have this sense of, oh, I actually accomplished it. It's done. Got anything to say on that?
Well, procrastination first, you're kind of throwing me for a loop there. So just quickly run by that by me again.
Okay. So
this was her one.
What is it that you keep putting off?
Okay.
So when you look at your list, and let's say, even the three or five things that you write down for the day, right, which one of those you keep putting off last, okay, and maybe it doesn't actually get accomplished? Okay. You need to do that one first.
Like setting my office up right now is when I'm procrastinating. It's driving me nuts.
Right. So when you come home, rather than doing the mowing the lawn,
right,
or fixing the whatever that needs to be fixed, you need to do your office.
Yeah.
Because every day you're thinking, I'm putting that off, but yet if you would have your office organized, your life would run smoother, right?
True,
you would find
true.
The lost things in your office. You would find the piece of paper that you've been looking for. Whatever, that procrastination is costing you time and distraction.
So your idea is get after that thing that you're procrastinating first, whether you get it done right that moment, but get it going.
Get
on
it
a regular
going.
Okay.
Because
I'm good with that.
Again,
I like that.
We spend so much energy thinking about it, and then we dwell on it, and then it holds us back. It's kind of what's holding you back. What do you keep putting off?
Right.
Okay, so it's procrastination first. The next one is prevent distractions. Okay, here we go. Stuff happens that we can't avoid. Okay, we can't avoid all distractions. I, as a mom, can't avoid when something happens in the kitchen and the kids need me. I can't avoid a kid needing some, like right now my son, he has work today and he can't find a pair of particular pants he has to wear for work, right? I can't avoid that. I need to help him. I don't know where the pants went. He doesn't know where they went. So those are distractions I can't avoid, right? But there are things that we allow to distract us. And what are those things? Determine your distractions. Is it sitting in front of the TV? Is it binge watching TV? Is it the internet?
Right.
Is it you just, like to hang out on the internet and keep looking through things? And one thing, we all know one thing leads to another, right? Is it social media? Are you just on social media all day long? You're reading Facebook, then you're over on Instagram, and then, I don't know, you're on Twitter, or you're on TikTok, whatever it is that distracting you from getting the things done that you're procrastinating against, the 3 to 5 things on your list? What is it that is keeping you? So do things doing things that can wait, right? That's the other thing. That's a distraction. Like I said, rather than going out and mowing the lawn, he could be cleaning his office. And that way, because the lawn can wait, right? But his office would help him move forward in his life.
Right. No, so, I agree. What we're doing is we're just trying to put off pain, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's the whole pain pleasure principle. It's like we'd rather do the pleasure first than the pain. Sometimes for me, mowing the lawn is really cathartic. I get to put on a headset, listen to a podcast, or I get to think. Where really, I need to just really focus on my office, even though the lawn needs to get done.
Right.
And I find that can happen, and I just have to really think about it. For me, what I have to do is I have to give myself the goal ahead of time. I have to think, okay, the office. So like tonight, I'm already thinking, when I come home, I'm not going to get distracted. 10 minutes, I'm going to go in there. So I just think 10 minutes, I can get it done.
Mm-hmm.
That's my little hack to get to make that happen.
Okay, so the next one is productivity. Being focused increases your productivity in all areas of your life. So how are you being productive, right? So being focused will increase that productivity. So you want to be focused on it so that you can be productive. So for me, I know that my morning times are the best, right? That generally when the kids have all left for work or used to leave for school, it was the quietest moments in the day. I could be the most productive then. It's why I even had to change my workout schedule before this whole quarantine thing. I had to change my workout schedule to be in the afternoon versus the morning because I'm the most productive in the morning. My brain is on. I'm focused. I'm increasing my productivity because I am on, right? I'm in my A game. But going and working out, I don't need to be in my A game necessarily. I'm going to push no matter what because I'm working out, right? Mm-hmm. So I had to change my schedule around to realize, wow, I was losing a good hour, hour and a half of my good thinking time going to the gym. So focus. When is your best productivity time? Focus in that area, right? Use that time. So is it after the kids go to bed at night? Is it before they get up? Does it mean you need to get up an hour earlier? What does it mean for you? So you, when you're focused, it actually increases your productivity. When you can't be focused, it doesn't.
Here's the thing that I do, and I love the top three things, is that what helps me be productive is when I know that there's 1 to 2 action steps I need to take mm-hmm. versus just thinking I have to do something, right? Like when I'm thinking, for instance, my office right now, I think, okay, tonight I'm going to put up more soundboard and I'm going to clean up what's on the floor. Those are 2 things I can do mm-hmm. that leads to that goal. That's how I do it.
You break it down. You're focused on just those rather than focusing on the whole project, right? The whole thing. Focus, narrow it down to little things. That's why I say, like in sound bites, like little tiny bite-sized pieces of organization. Break it down. When you are looking like, let's say, at your bedroom or your children's bedroom or the kitchen, break it down. Like, okay, tonight after dinner, you're just going to clean the silverware drawer out, right? You can be focused on that. You can be productive on that. Just that one little area versus thinking, I'm going to take on the whole kitchen. So break it down.
And that's what he's talking about. Who wants to clean the silverware drawer?
Me, because I like when I look in the drawer, it's all neat and tidy.
But yeah, I'm glad she likes to do that.
I like everything. I like to open drawers and see that they're all put away, right? It's
probably absolutely. I'm all for that.
And the last thing is, give yourself a prize. Reward yourself when you stay productive. Yeah. Reward yourself when you can stay focused for the day. Let yourself then spend some time on social media if that's your gig. Let yourself spend time reading if that's your thing or binge watching at night. Right. But make sure you've done those 3 to 5 things, right? That you've been productive, that you have figured out how to stay focused and be productive.
Right. And here's the deal. It's a daily struggle, right? Mm-hmm. And struggle's not bad. We struggle mm-hmm. in everything. That's part of how we grow. Yeah. Struggling and growing are the same things. So if you have a bad productive day, just shake that off. You wake up in the morning, it's a new day. Mm-hmm. It's a new day to ready to go do something.
Yeah.
So we encourage you with that. Is that your phone?
I think that's my phone reminding me something. See, I set my phone for alarms to remind me of different things throughout the day. And this one is to
get a gift for Ellis.
I already did that one. That was last week. I guess I said it for every Tuesday. Already did that one. I need to delete that alarm. Anyways, so we're going to wrap it up here. We gave you some 6 tips basically of how to get productive, how to get things done. And I want to remind you that this Thursday night is the biggest, greatest, funnest, bestest, whatever, if those are even words, Moms Night In, right here, 24/7 Moms. We are going live on Facebook with a fun Moms Night In.
Fingers crossed for the technology.
Yeah, his problem, not mine. So we've got tons of giveaways. They just keep arriving at my door all day long. It was like 9 o'clock the other night and prizes arrived at my door. So we're going to have tons of prizes. We're going to have mom tips that we're going to share with you. We're going to play a game, hopefully. My co-host and I will play a game. You'll laugh. You'll have fun. You'll get to chat with other moms. You'll just get to hang out, get a little time for yourself. So right now, talk to your husband. Figure out how you're going to get a little bit of time away, hide out in your bathroom, your bedroom. I don't care where you go and hide out, but let's have some mom time. It's Thursday night, May 7th. I almost said March. May 7th, 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 8 o'clock Eastern Time. You got to join in. It's going to be fun. We'll probably go for a couple hours. We're just going to have great mom time that we all need right now.
Now, I can tell you too, ladies, that she comes up with some really good swag. We have several companies of unique small and big companies that have new products that they want moms to have. Mm-hmm. And so you're going to enjoy this as well as, I mean, I've seen vacuum cleaners that look like they're for the space shuttle. Yeah. I don't know what the deal is about them these days, but they look great.
I also just had a big phone call yesterday with a company that is going to revolutionize chores and behaviors in your house. I'm telling you, I got the new item you're going to want. So you're going to want to tune in Thursday, May 7th, 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 8 o'clock Eastern Time. We will see you then, and I'll catch you tomorrow at another episode of Mom Knit Daily. Thanks for joining us.
Take care. Bye.